Going to Germany, I always thought that it would just hit me. I'm in Germany. It would just be this strange thing. But when I came to Germany or flew in, it really felt pretty normal. It felt pretty, I don't know. I mean, it's still a different country, but it kind of just, they rolled right into it. Got in cars and we drove down. And I remember that drive is indistinctly in my mind because, in Germany, everyone drives a lot different. It's a lot quicker and you zip in and out of people and there's a lot more one lane roads. I mean, it's two lane road, but it's as wide as our one lane roads. So Berlin, I was just in one part of it, called Neukölln, which is actually one of the larger areas where there's immigrants. So we have people from Turkey, we have people from Africa, people from all around the world live everywhere in Germany, but there's a high percentage that live in Neukölln. So that was, really an interesting thing. So I was in Germany, but I also met many cultures from around the world, and I got to know, experience many different cultures. But Germany as a whole, I guess what's unique about it is that it's a large city. It's 3.5 million people. But what's interesting is it's not like New York where you have these skyscrapers. There's really not that many tall buildings. It's very spread out. It's a large area, and most of the buildings are, a good height, but they're not incredibly tall. So that was something unique to me. The homes are smaller than American homes. Things are more expensive there as far as, housing and electricity and those things go. Getting around is really cool though. They have a great subway system and a great bus system. There's a bus or a train coming every 4 or 5 minutes. No matter where you are, you can get anywhere. It's really efficient. That was really a great way to get around. I don't think I really ever used a bike in Berlin because it's just, such a good system. And what's also cool about Berlin is the history. I think Germany as a whole is one of the countries that's been involved in most of the world history. And Berlin is, one of those cities that you see in history textbooks. You see pictures of the Brandenburger Tor, which is the four-pillared, sort of gate-looking thing with the horses on top. The Berliner Dome is one of the oldest, cathedrals that there is. There's just really these, these things you see in books. And when you're in Berlin for a while, it's, certain areas you'll see them off every day. You walk past these, incredibly influential or these important pieces of history. There's all sorts of museums, all sorts of artifacts from the World Wars. Really cool, interesting things. One of the most interesting to me was the Berlin Wall. There's still pieces of it that are up. And you can actually, where it's not up, you can actually see a pretty good, I wouldn't say a line. It's not really a line anymore, but it transitions pretty quickly when you cross where the wall was. Just very different building styles, Yeah, it's pretty interesting to see that. The actual wall they have, they've turned into art galleries, and really, put an influential spin on sort of those things, which is a pretty cool monument, I guess. It's a city that's alive. You feel the energy. I've never lived in a big city, or I had never lived in one until that point. And so that was a big change. But it was really exciting. There's always people to talk to. There's always people. It's just a real life to that city. But yeah, in Germany, I mean, it's pretty similar to America, I would actually say, culture-wise. And I think it's become more American, or it's, the world has become, more similar to one another. But there's definitely still some differences. I think the first thing people seem to notice is that the people there, they have their personal space and they seem more maybe closed off. But I really discovered that it's just this front, Once you get past this front, then you meet these wonderful people and they're incredible and they just have great hearts. When you win the heart of a German, I feel like you have a loyal friend. Germans are really honest, They're upfront with you. If they're not interested, they're not interested. If they think your haircut looks bad, then they'll tell you. But they also res they respect honesty in return. I find it's a positive thing most of the time, just that upfront honesty. It's funny when you talk to someone in a bus or a train. At first they're usually like, why are you talking to me? Like we don't know each other. But it's exciting, it's fun, and they remember, the guy who talked to me in a train. How weird that is. When you're eating with a family, you always keep both hands on the table. Americans, we tend to have one hand on our lap and the other hand eating, but they always have both hands on the table, and you eat with both hands, your fork and your knife. That's something that's actually a lot more efficient than how we eat here. I was always taught that you hold your fork in this hand, you cut with your knife, then you set your knife down, switch hands. I don't know if that's how everyone's taught, but that's somehow what I had. And I always loved their drinks. They always mix drinks. They have mineral Wasser, which is, what is it, fizzy water, mineral or club soda, something like that. And they mix it with these juices, you know. And it's just something that's actually really great. They have really good juices there. As far as holidays go, they have a lot of holidays. Christmas is an exciting time. I feel like the Germans had a lot of influence on what we now have as Christmas. And so you go there, they have Christmas markets, which are just great. There's, you know, woodwork, there's all kinds of food, there's, you know, a lot of traditional things you'll find at these Christmas markets. And that's just a fun time of year. And I can honestly say that the two Christmases I spent in Germany were, you know, two of the most special that I've ever seen or experienced.